Welcome to the Model Health Show. This is fitness and nutrition expert Shawn Stevenson here with my amazing, beautiful, talented, brilliant co-host and producer of the Model Health Show, Jade Harrell. What's up, Jade?
What's up, Shawn?
How are you today?
Today? I was going to say tonight.
Tonight.
I am dynactionated.
Whoa.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, tell me about that.
I am really motivated to take action in a dynamic way.
Oh, wow. Okay. That sounded like, you know, when Voltron comes together, because you know you got the five separate cats,
yeah.
You know, and now forms the legs. You know, when
right.
they come together, that was some Voltron level stuff.
That's it,
there.
Yeah.
I respect
that's where
I'm
at. I appreciate it.
I appreciate
yes,
that.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Or shout out to, if people don't know about Voltron. Well first of all, I'm sorry for you.
Yeah.
But then they got like the Power Rangers, right?
Oh, sure, you know, sure, sure.
We can't disrespect the Power
yeah.
Rangers. You know they got a new movie coming out too, a reboot. Everybody's rebooting everything.
Absolutely. All right?
It's basically what's happening, which is so cool, is that people from earlier generations, you know, even when I was growing up, they're becoming movie producers now. They're yeah. becoming directors. And they're just like, you know what? I always loved Ninja Turtles, so we're going to make this
That's
into
right.
a thing.
That was the one I was going to bring up. We were here in the field about Teenage Mutant
it's powerful.
Ninja Turtles.
And we're connected.
That's right.
We're like peanut butter and lamb sandwich.
Yes.
No, just kidding. That's from Big Daddy. Shout out to Big Daddy. One of my kids' favorite movies. Watched it so many times.
I pretty
much know it word for word.
Mm-hmm.
But anyways, guys, we got a great show lined up for you guys today. I am super, super excited. And just, my goodness, I'm very proud to have this individual on our show today. He's a great friend of mine and somebody who's just been a leader, an icon in the world of podcasting, period, but just a leader in showing people how to do this and do it in a big way. He's just uber successful. And he came from really, again, he had no idea about any of this stuff just a little over like 4 years ago. You know, he had no online presence and now he's grown that into just a thriving community, his show, his entities, and he's also serving the community in a big way with Pencils of Promise, building schools. It's just amazing, absolutely amazing individual. He's got a heart just the size. You know how when you remember in the Grinch, right? You remember in the Grinch, his heart was like two sizes too small or whatever, and then he kind of went too big.
That's right. That's right.
He's got that too big heart. All right, too big heart. He's got
that
a huge heart.
Warmed up everything. Uh-huh.
And just a good friend, and I'm grateful to have him on to really talk about a huge component to our livelihood, which is being able to accomplish our goals. You know, that's really what it's about as far as moving humanity forward and moving our lives forward in general. Now, when I speak about this, I'm coming from a place of balance in my perspective, integrating, you know, understand that there is both sides of the story of not just chasing after something, going after your goal, but also enjoying now, you know, being here in the present and allowing life to happen. And I think it's this unique blend and being able to point your locus of focus on something beyond where you are right now, being able to have a goal to move again. Life is all constantly moving forward to move towards that direction, but also being able to enjoy the process and enjoy the now. So this is, it's kind of part and parcel to making the magic happen and having actual fulfillment. It's not the
That's
thing.
Right. That's right.
It's the process.
Yeah.
And the process that I experience utilizing a tool that he shared that he's going to talk about last year. Oh my goodness. It changed my reality. It really did, because I was able to enjoy the process. I was able to structure things in my life like I've never structured before, to accomplish things like I've never accomplished before. Mm-hmm. And it's because he said yes to putting this tool together. Right. I literally could not believe how much I got done and how much I accomplished.
And that changed things for us
The show, it definitely
Everything.
Experienced that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so being able to have that goal of having the number one podcast on iTunes in the country in the health section was a goal for many years ago. We were able to hit that goal and surpass it many times over. But the consistency, to consistently reach more and more people and to serve at a higher and higher level, that is a hard thing to master, you know, until you fully embrace this process.
Yeah.
And so that's what we're going to be talking about today. So
right.
I'm very excited, and also excited because you know what I had today? I had this amazing reishi tea. So let me tell you about this reishi
Come
tea.
On, tell
All right.
Me.
So reishi, and this is four sigmatic, by the way,
okay.
guys, if you're not
okay.
on four sigmatic, I don't know what you're doing. I don't know what you're, what are you doing? It's four sigmatic. So I had this reishi today. I'm really feeling reishi. And reishi is, when you look at Chinese medicine, it talks, this one is working on your shin, mm-hmm. right? So this is S-H-E-N. It's more of the kind of, quote, spiritual energy, uh-huh. right? But if you look at the science, the real hard science on this, reishi is absolutely phenomenal. What's seen clinically is an increase in your NK cells activity over 300%. So this is helping to train your immune system, your natural killer cells, to basically protect your body from any nefarious thing that you're exposed to. So it's really gifted in being an immunomodulating substance to the degree that there are very few things on the planet that can help to regulate your immune system so well, meaning that not just making your immune system work more, but if it needs to come down, it can help to bring it down too, because many people are experiencing autoimmunity where their immune system is running too hot. So it helps to bring that down. Right. And why I love it so much is the fact that it's dual extracted. So it's extracted via hot water extraction as well as alcohol extraction. So you're getting all of the beneficial compounds. You can't get everything from that incredible resource with just one extraction mm-hmm. method. And that's mm-hmm. really how a lot of supplements fall short right. and four sigmatic doesn't. So you get the triterpene compounds. You get the, like, kind of steroidal compounds that help with energy and hormone function, that kind of stuff. And you also get the beta glucans and all the antioxidants and all the amazing things together. And it tastes mm-hmm. so good, especially. And so, by the way, so head over, check that out. So it's reishi is the one that I've been using lately. I've been a huge fan of the lion's mane, the cordyceps, the mushroom coffees, the hot chocolates. Oh my goodness. Too, yeah. And you know what time it is. You know this time of year. Yes. So my family really enjoys the hot chocolates as well. Head over, check them out. It's foursigmatic.com/model. So that's foursigmatic.com/model. So that's foursigmatic.com/model. And you're going to get 15% off all of their incredible mushroom elixirs. This is critical today because your immune system has never been exposed to such chaos. You know, there's so many things that have never existed before in human history. You know, 21 billion pounds of synthetic chemicals being dropped into our environment every single year. More than that, by the way. But it's just, you've got to make sure that you're taking action to make sure, this is real health insurance, to make sure that your body is insured against all this nefarious stuff that you're exposed to. And it's not just in the air that we're breathing, our food supply, our water, even if you're eating organic food, it's not guaranteed that you're going mm-hmm. to be not exposed to things that your immune system is going to be needing to get on top of. So I absolutely love these guys. I've been using these, I mean, I'm not kidding, every day. And everything that I do has a purpose, but this is built into my daily routine, my rituals. Every single day I'm having a four sigmatic elixir, and I love blending in the MCT oils, emulsified MCT oils, and I use those from Onnit. So the emulsified MCT oil from Onnit, this is literally immediate cell food. It bypasses the normal digestion that would need to be required to get the goodies from it. It goes directly to your cells as cellular energy. That's what you're getting from these medium chain triglycerides. Mm-hmm. And by being emulsified, you can actually mix it in pretty well with your drinks just by stirring it. She's shaking it like a maraca. Shake it like a Polaroid picture. Lucy Lou's. All right. So they have the flavors, the strawberry, and that's what I had today, strawberry emulsified MCT oil. I did not know that I would like it so much. Ah. Yeah, so I've had that with the reishi. Then they have coconut. Yeah, mm-hmm. they have coconut. Mm-hmm. They have vanilla as well, but they also have just the original MCT oil, not emulsified as well, for people who want that. And I have all of them. Yeah. All right. And I have all of the four sigmatic teas as well, but they go great together. And I also add in maybe a little bit of another full fat. So maybe it's grass fed butter or ghee, or maybe even coconut oil. Sometimes I'll throw that in there. And the emulsified oils are really easy to travel with because they don't require that blender mm-hmm. to try to mm-hmm. get it all to mix together. So head over there, check them out. Also, they've got the hemp forest protein, which I use on a consistent basis. Also give to my kids. Most bioavailable source of protein for the human body is likely going to be what you find in hemp, with the albumin and the edestin as well. Plus you're getting all of the macro minerals, macronutrients along with that to make it more of a real food your body can recognize, right? Without all of the crazy processing that you're going to get with a lot of the whey products out there. So it's just much healthier. And it's also using earth-grown nutrients. That's what Onnit does, is using earth-grown nutrients for all of their supplements. And also their fitness equipment is amazing. So head over, check them out, onnit.com shawnandrew.com/model for 10% off. Now, let's get to the iTunes review of the week.
Well, this one is nice as well. Changing lives with 5-star from TW Review. I am rarely at a loss for words, but I find it hard to summarize what the Model Health Show is doing. The podcast is not only fun to listen to, it is truly life-changing. I tell everyone that I know facing a health issue that they should listen. Shawn and Jade are fun and engaging. These two have that unique ability to take complex information and translate it into language that those of us without medical degrees can understand. And better yet, how to implement the info to make you better. Thank you so much for giving so much of yourselves and changing our world one episode at a time. Sending lots of love to you both.
Oh, man. I love that so much.
Me too.
Being at a loss for words to describe, that's a good thing. That's right, how I feel about you. You're as like, well. I don't really
just stammering.
Jade, she is. Yeah, she's Jade.
Right. As long as you're smiling with that, because that could be like, I'm not so sure.
You're the best. You look phenomenal today, by the way.
Thank
I love
you, sir.
The jewelry, as DJ Khaled would say, jewelry.
Jewelry. Well, I'm learning to utilize some of the metals and stones as things that give good vibration and just add to my positive energy.
You're talking about vibration. Huh?
Good vibration.
Oh, so, and then we got a song by it, too.
Well, you know. And I bet they didn't. The Beach Boys didn't expect that to go with onyx here and copper.
But everything is energy. Everything has an energy.
Exactly.
And the way the atoms are doing their thing.
Yeah.
And it's incredible. You know, this whole science of feng shui.
Yeah.
You know, when you look at how even things are set up and how it changes your chemistry, your brain chemistry, your blood chemistry, your mood. Mm-hmm. It's powerful stuff. And of course, we're going to be talking about that this year on the Model Health Show. So really excited about that. But nothing is more important than this moment today, right now, to tune in and really focus on what our special guest has to say.
Absolutely.
And right now I have in my hands this amazing Freedom Journal. So this Freedom Journal, the Freedom Journal, Accomplish Your Goal in 100 Days,
so
was absolutely paramount in the success of Sleep Smarter. It happened to come right at the very beginning of the book launch process, and it is filled to the brim. Like every page
that.
Is filled with morsels of goodness and accomplishment,
Shawn.
And focus. And I have never in my life accomplished so much.
That's right.
Even outside of the one goal,
mm-hmm.
so much because of the structure and motivation of this journal. Not only was it just because of the way that he structured out the questions,
right,
the way that he structured out the objectives, but also because of the beauty of it.
Absolutely.
You know, it's like, it's this sexy thing, this thing that made me want to touch it and to write on it every day. And it's really been my most prized companion in that process, outside of my wife.
Well,
no offense, I'm not touching this and trying to cause a problem.
I did rub it. I have a confession.
Wait a minute, you touched my book.
Not your book.
Okay,
got my own.
Okay, no disrespect.
Which was
then.
Paradigm
All right,
shifting.
Because that gets
for
a little
too.
Weird. That's kind of weird. All right. So, but
he
this
made
this
copies.
I cannot
you.
Tell you.
Oh, I'm so grateful.
I'm speaking right from my heart. This is real.
Yeah.
This helped me to accomplish more than I have ever accomplished in my life.
Come on.
In just 100 days.
See.
And it's because of this man stepping up and saying yes to making it happen. And
he did.
John Lee Dumas, our guest of the show, our friend today. John Lee Dumas is the host of EO Fire, where he interviews today's most successful entrepreneurs 7 days a week, a 7-day-a-week podcast.
Wow.
JLD, affectionately known, JLD, has grown EO Fire into a multi-million dollar a year business with over 1,500 interviews and 1.5 million monthly listens.
Go ahead.
His latest project is the Mastery Journal.
Oh.
Master Productivity, Discipline, and Focus in 100 Days. You can learn more at themasteryjournal.com. And I'd like to welcome to the Model Health Show my friend, John Lee Dumas. How you doing today, man?
Shawn, can we clear the rest of our schedules and just spend the entire day together? Because I just get this vibe, this glow when I'm hanging out with you. Which is why I extended it to you privately, and now I'm extending to you publicly. Come visit me in Puerto Rico with your amazing family.
Let's go.
Yes.
Going to be amazing. And I will say, few things in life have made me happier than when we got on this call and you held up the Freedom Journal and you flipped through the pages, and like everyone was just slathered yes. with your writing, like chock full. And it Absolutely. Just made my heart leap because, you know, this is something that I labored over for a year and studied and put together this thing, but you still never know, like, is it really going to impact impactful people? And, yeah. and you're an impactful person. Yeah. You inspire so many people. And so to see that meant the world. So thank you, brother.
Oh man, wow. I received that and it's my honor, man. And you know, it's just, I was talking to my wife today. I was like, guess who's coming on the show? John Lee Dumas. And then just a little glimmer in her eye, she's like, I know you're happy, right? I was like, yes.
He's
one of my favorite people, man. One of my favorite people. Just being able to hang out with you and to be able to see this come to fruition and to impact. And the thing was, it's like, I thought it was a pretty good idea, mm-hmm. but when I used it myself, I was like, this was the most amazing. I'm so grateful that he stepped up and did this mm-hmm. because this was outside of your wheelhouse. You know, you had this mega huge online thing, you know, with the podcast and all the things that come off of that. But then to make a physical product right. and to truly impact influencers is just mind blowing. And I want to talk about that. So what has this last year been like since launching the Freedom Journal? What kind of changes have you seen? What results have you kind of experienced and heard from people? Just talk a little bit more about it.
So I think a quote that can really kick this off in a good way and was really my inspiration for the Freedom Journal was a Mark Twain quote, which is, whenever you find yourself on the side of the majority, it's time to pause and reflect. That doesn't mean that that's a wrong, that's a bad thing, but it's time to just be like, you know, am I just doing this because everybody's doing it? Mm. And I found myself there in 2014, you know, with courses and with virtual and apps and PDFs and everything in the cloud. And I was like, okay, that's a good thing. And I have continued to do that. But I said, what can I do that's not on the side of the majority? Where can I zig when everybody's zagging?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Wow.
And that was a physical product. That was coming back to the core. And to me, that ended up being what I realized my guests, like you, Shawn, have in common, which is you know how to set and accomplish goals. So I wanted to bring that to my listeners, to Fire Nation. So we did that launch, and you were a massive supporter and you know, huge, awesome person within that last January of 2016. And it just simply crushed. I mean, it just struck a chord with people, and it became the sixth most funded publishing campaign of all time.
Wow.
Did 453K in 33 days.
Wait,
of
say,
that Kickstarter.
Say that again. Say it again, John.
$453,000 in those 33 days
Amazing.
Of that Kickstarter campaign.
Wow.
But one thing I really want to note on this point, because for people that are listening, I know that your listeners don't just want to like make money in this world. They want to make an impact. And that's what we tied in with the Freedom Journal campaign. We partnered with Pencils of Promise. And every time we hit a funding level, I wrote a check on behalf of the Freedom Journal supporters for $25,000 to build a school in a developing country. And Shawn, to date, three schools have been built. Over $75,000 has been donated. And it's not just from me, it's from the supporters of the Freedom Journal. Everybody who's invested in accomplishing their number one goal has also been a part of that investing in other people's education in developing countries. So that was a really cool thing. And you always have to wonder, like, after that big launch happens, you know, 453K in 33 days, like, does it just drop off a cliff? And in some cases it does. And that's happened to me before with past launches. But the Freedom Journal has just kept having legs and it's been consistent too. Like every single month we're doing between $25,000 to $35,000 in revenue every single month from this $39 journal, by the way. So hundreds into thousands of people every single month are buying this because number one, they're realizing the power of it. But number two, they're realizing that they're continuing to impact something like Pencils of Promise because we're continuing to put a portion of every sale towards that as well. We have people, Shawn, in their third Freedom Journal right now. They're on their way to accomplishing their third goal in 100 days, and it's just mind-blowing to see.
Yeah, and I shared this with you that after my initial fling with my Freedom Journal and crushing for those 100 days, I definitely saw that slow decline in my productivity and in my accomplishments. And it's just so silly. Like, why did, but you know, that's the thing about me too. I'm always experimenting, I'm always trying different things. And so I tried some different things, but nothing has been more powerful. And to even hear the price point, for me, that's like, it is a no-brainer because of all the value. And everybody listening was a part of that. You were actually a part of all the things that I accomplished and taking the show from where it was to basically tripling our listenership, our downloads, seeing the show consistently in the top 10 on iTunes now in our category versus, you know, being in there, you know, maybe once a month or whatever. And also the quality of shows, the quality of content, the guests that we brought on, all of that was all structured in this, in that time period, all while I was launching a book.
I was going to say, don't forget the book and the audio book.
Yeah. And so this is what this is really about, is being able to focus on the thing that you most desire and bringing it to fruition, because it can happen.
Absolutely.
You know, our show is the Model Health Show. And so we talk about all things that influence your health and well-being. And part of that is you being productive. Mm-hmm. Part of that is you accomplishing your goals, whether it's health-related or business-related or family-related. It's being healthy in all areas and being fulfilled in your life. And today we live at the time of the greatest distraction. And this is the gift that John has brought to the table, is helping us to focus in and move away from that distraction. So I'm curious now, because with the Mastery Journal, right, which I love the name.
Right.
The Freedom Journal already hit me. I don't know how you came up with this. It's so simple, but it's like, yes, the Mastery Journal. So what's the big difference here? So the Freedom Journal we've got right here in my hand, but what is this, the Mastery Journal? What's that all about?
So the Mastery Journal, which I actually do have in my hand, and Shawn, which you will soon as well, by the way, you know, it's, we're not going to change what works. I mean, it's the same gorgeous faux leather, because I am an animal lover. You know, we did a little silver, so it's silver instead of gold, but you know, it's just high quality. So we just stuck with that. But the contents within, now this is where we really went the next level. So for the Freedom Journal, you know, for me, that was listening to my listeners of EO Fire and them saying, what do all of your guests have in common? And that was that thing that I mentioned earlier in the show, that my guests know how to set and accomplish goals. So the Freedom Journal is your step-by-step guide to setting one goal in this very crazy world of distractions and accomplishing that one goal in 100 days. Boom, done. Now, of course, like within that, there's those micro goals every 10 days, the quarterly reviews. I mean, it's a very unique system, step-by-step-by-step. So that launch, that was a success. And I was watching people go through the Freedom Journal accomplishing this massive goal. And then they were saying, John, okay, I've accomplished this massive goal. Like, what's next? Should I accomplish my next major goal? And for some people, the answer is yes. But for other people, the answer is, well, maybe you've just accomplished this big goal, like launching a podcast or a book or whatever it might be. Maybe now it's time to double down on what you just accomplished. And what are you going to do to really keep that momentum going and amplify it to the next level? Well, the answer is you need to become a master of productivity. You need to master your discipline and master your focus to take this win that you just experienced and take it to that next level. And so that's where the idea for the Mastery Journal came from, because a lot of people were, again, curious about what my guest's biggest strengths were, and that was the setting and accomplishing goals. But then a lot of questions in 2016 coming to me were, John, like, now for years you've run EO Fire as a multi-million dollar a year profit business. Like, how are you doing that? What are your individual greatest strengths? Because, you know, I've now proven myself as an entrepreneur, whereas, you know, year one, year two, like, it was my guests, they were the highlight. Now year three, four, and I'm moving into year five. Now my guests and myself, you know, have really proven ourselves over the track record. So looking inwards, I was saying, man, three skills that I've mastered, and I didn't have them mastered from day one, but I've mastered them over these past 4+ years, are productivity. I'm a producing machine. Discipline. I had it hammered into me from the Army, and I was able to turn that into discipline for entrepreneurship as well. And that's a huge skill. And then focus. It's my favorite acronym, Shawn. Follow one course until success. Those are my three greatest strengths. Now, we would have to hang out all day if I was going to talk about my weaknesses, because that doesn't end. Like, that's just countless, like all human beings. But as humans, if we can focus in on our strengths, and if you can create your strengths into being productive, disciplined, and focused, you win. You might not win tomorrow or next month, but you will win. It's just a matter of when. And so that's what I did with the Mastery Journal. I created an amazing system. I brought in some proven time-stamped things such as the Pomodoro technique, Parkinson's Law. It's just incredible mesh of everything that I've been studying for a year on those three skills. And in 100 days, again, this is a JLD guarantee, you will be a master of productivity, of discipline, and of focus if you follow the system, just like if, like Shawn did, he followed the system for the Freedom Journal and he accomplished things that still blow his mind to this day.
Yeah. You know what? This is really speaking to something like it just started to really jump out in my consciousness that a lot of people struggle with their health and well-being because of discipline, because of focus, because of productivity, you know, doing the right things at the right time and being consistent in that. And these are all kind of pitfalls for us in our character, but we all have the capacity for them. It's just having a system. It's having some guidance. Nobody taught me how to be productive.
No.
Nobody taught me how to focus. And it's just like, and today focus is also at a minimum just because of the sheer nature of all the distraction in the world.
That's right.
But also now we're taught that my lack of focus is a medical condition, you know? And so this is something that I need to treat with a drug. And we're not even taught how to do it or why it matters, what it is. So let's start there, actually. So let's start from the top. So productivity, what does this mean to you and why does this really matter?
So something that we chatted about pre-interview, Shawn, that I think is kind of key to bring up now, you know, you were thanking me for something that I brought into your life, you know, just like I have thanked you profusely for the, you know, the health and the fitness and the well-being that you brought into my life when you were my mentor in the health and fitness arena. You know, you said, John, like a lot of things of what we do today in our business is thanks to you. Like number one of those things you said, batching, like, you know, you just don't do one show a week anymore. Sometimes you do two, maybe even three shows. And then that gives you time that you're able to take back and do other things and be more productive. So batching for me was a massive breakthrough in my business when I wanted to do a 7-day a week podcast. And this is going to blow some people's minds, I will admit, because this is something I could not have done day one. It's like training for a marathon when you're 10 pounds overweight. You don't go run 26 miles. You walk and then you jog. And then you finally over, you know, 6 months, whatever it might be, you finally get to the point where you can run that 26 miles, whatever your training regimen is. For me, I've built up over these past 4 years to where now I do 30 interviews in 2 days, 15 interviews on the first Monday, and 15 interviews on the first Tuesday of every single month. And what does that do? Number one, that makes sure that those 2 days, I'm just bringing the heat because I know those are my 2 days to win. That's my Super Bowl, Shawn. Mm. That is my football Super Bowl right there. And I bring it all day, every single day for those 2 days. Then those other 28 days, they're mine. I can do other things like come on your show, like write the mastery journal, do this, do that, all these different things. You know, a mutual friend of ours, Pat Flynn, was inspired by my batching a couple of years ago, and he launched Ask Pat, which he said he never could have done or mentally even thought about if he didn't realize what batching could do. So now he does that 5-day-a-week show just a couple of days a month, just like I've been able to produce that. So that's huge. And so to really break down this word productivity, you need to ask yourself this question. What are you producing on a daily basis that's meaningful to your life and your business? And the answer, unfortunately, for most people is not much. And the reason for that is three letters, OPA. You wake up in the morning and you get on other people's agenda. That's what you do. You open up your email inbox, you're putting out other people's fires, you go in your Facebook news feed, you respond to messages, you start your day and you give the best of yourself. That when you're fully rested, when you wake up alert and alive after, you know, a shower, maybe a workout, that's when you got to produce your best work. And so many people waste that on other people's agenda. I get it. I live in the real world. That has to happen at some point during the day, but it doesn't have to happen during your best core hours to create. So produce things that matter first thing in the morning. That's what being productive is all about. Now, that's going to move into discipline very nicely, but I want to stop there, Shawn, to see if you have any feedback.
Oh, man. Yeah, of course. You know, we've seen this across the board where, you know, we wake up and we start putting out fires. Like you've got all of these great goals for yourself. Like I'm going to crush it tomorrow. I'm going to do all this stuff to create what you want in your life, whether it's regarding your health, your finances, whatever it is. And we hop on our phone and start answering emails or even going on social media. Mm-hmm. Right. And it becomes this huge distraction and starts to pull us away from the things that we really want to focus on. And so he just said it very perfectly, OPA. It reminds me of OPP,
yeah.
Other People's Property.
I think every time we talk, by the way, that comes up somehow, OPP.
You're so right.
But
yeah,
it's so
know
funny.
Me.
But one thing I want to make a point on this is there's one word, Shawn, that I know is going to resonate with you and hopefully it resonates with your listeners as well. But the word's residue. And like, what does that mean? Like, you may think it's okay just to jump in and do a couple quick emails, but guess what? That residue that you just did of putting out other people's fires, that's going to stay with you the rest of the day. That's going to be with you even when you go on to that next task because you just wanted to answer a couple quick emails. That stays with you, and that really waters down that amazing creativity time that you have. That residue will stay with you. So just realize that. And how many people, raise your hand because I'm there for sure, you know, have said, I'm going to go into my email real quick and just write an email to somebody. That's all you're planning on doing is just writing an email. But then you go to your inbox and what happens? You see there's 7 unread messages. So you write your quick email. Then you're like, well, I just got to answer these messages real quick. Yeah. And then message number 5 of 7 is some fire that you need to now put out. In the next hour, you're like, oh my, I just went in there to write a quick email. And now I've been doing this for the last hour. And it's been absolutely distracting to the nth degree. Mm-hmm. There's a great tool called Inbox Pause, where you can just pause your inbox. And so no emails can come into you. I mean, they all come in, but they're just stored where you can't see them. And then you can unpause and it will just shoot them all in your inbox. But so then if you have to go send that message, you go to an empty inbox or an inbox zero that you've already created, and you can just do that and come back. And you only unpause when you're ready to actually tackle your inbox.
Mm. That's taking back ownership of what matters. And that's the thing.
Love
you know,
that,
Jim. It's a fire, of course. So, you know, naturally you're going to go put out a fire because that's urgent. That's important. But when you said produce the things that matter most in the morning or that matter in the morning, because you're going to run across several things that will matter throughout the course of the day, throughout your life. Like we were talking about in another episode, the curveballs that get
kids throw us,
all of that. But by establishing that as what matters tremendously happens first in the morning, then that gives us a little bit of buffer to not make that happen and take over.
Yeah. And that productivity. So that's really one of the gateways, but also discipline. This is a word that, and I've talked about this many times, it starts to conjure up discomfort.
Of course.
You know, it's like, I don't want discipline.
Don't discipline.
You know, like,
me.
It's so much negative tied to it. But for me personally, and of course, I want to hear your opinion on this, but I see it as such a beautiful gift. You know, like, it's the root is disciple, you know, and so it's being a disciple of whatever it is that you're focused on. You know, I'm a disciple of this goal, I'm a disciple of this path, I'm a disciple of myself. Becoming more of a disciple of yourself.
That's right.
And that breeds that discipline is breeding that, you know. So adding a new neural connection to the word,
right.
But discipline really creates freedom. Funny enough. So
there's a loyalty in that too.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
As a disciple, you're loyal, you're committed, you're devoted to that.
So let's talk about discipline, man. Why is it such a huge thing for you, and why does this matter in this whole context?
Well, first off, I'm stealing that whole disciple thing, and I'm gonna give you credit twice, Shawn. And it's mine. So
that's it.
You got it, bro. You've given me enough. It's yours. I want those 2 times, though.
Yeah, right.
Oh, I love it. So okay. I totally agree. Sometimes the word discipline gives people kind of the weebie-jeebies. Like, I totally get that. But just like you said at the end there, Shawn, discipline, really what it does, it opens up freedom in your life, because if you are disciplined during X hours, that gives you Y hours. Because if you can really do that well and be disciplined and committed to that cause, now instead of that thing just kind of like, you know, like just produced, you know, out to the whole day, which by the way, comes back to Parkinson's law, which I'll share with you in a second. Now you can just say, okay, I'm disciplined to this. And so then that when I get home with the wife and kids, I'm all in, I'm focused, and you're actually there and you're present. So yeah. Parkinson's law is tasks will expand to the time allotted. So if you don't allot a certain amount of time to something, you won't accomplish it in any time frame. So you have to, that's just how you click your brain into that next gear. And within the Mastery Journal, I have 4 daily sessions that you have to have a focus time and a refresh time. And it will make more sense like when you see it and I walk you through it through the intro. But for me, I know that I can sit down and I have my 42 minutes of focus time and then my 18 minutes of refresh time. So what does that mean for me? It means I know that I can just do that one task for 42 minutes, knowing that I have an 18-minute break coming up where I can go, you know, maybe go for a quick walk listening to the Model Health Show and pick up some quick, you know, some fitness and health tips. And I can maybe, you know, flip on Daily V to watch Gary Vaynerchuk real quick during that 18 minutes. So you trick your brain into saying, hey, I'm gonna give you 18 minutes of like that refresh time where you can just relax for in exchange for that 42 minutes of focus time. And by the way, those numbers are my numbers, JLD's numbers. You got to come up with your own. Like, those have come to me over the years, and I'm still adjusting and tweaking. It's what works for me right now. And I train you in the Master Journal how to find your current numbers and how to adjust them going forward. But getting back to the core of discipline, I was in the Army for 8 years, 4 active, 4 in the reserves, and that was hammered into me, discipline, 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 some good habits, some bad habits. And I was able to take that learning and apply it to entrepreneurship early on. So that was really the first of those 3 skills that I mastered as an entrepreneur. And what that means is, and within the Mastery Journal, you win tomorrow today. Now, that phrase right there starts with the discipline of the night before you write out your morning routine. There's 9 slots, and you write out your entire morning routine, step 1 to step 9. And of course, if you have more things, there's more space. And if you have less things, that's fine. You don't have to do 9, but you have that thing written down so that when you wake up in the morning, your mind's not just adrift of like, what do I do first? Like, maybe I'll just jump into that inbox real quick again. Again, that's what will happen. You'll get sucked in towards that. So be disciplined, win tomorrow today by writing down that plan the night before. So you wake up with that disciplined plan that you execute on step by step by step. And by the way, that first thing better be your most meaningful task, because like Brian Tracy says, eat that frog. Don't keep that task hanging over your head. Do that thing first that scares you the most. Then the rest of the day's gravy, baby.
Yes, yes.
Man. And not that like, you know, fatty gravy, but like that healthy gravy.
Like that. Paleo gravy.
That's it.
Yeah,
is
like
that
bone broth.
Is that paleo?
Gelatin.
There it is.
Is that,
the bone broth.
Is that paleo?
Paleo.
Bone
gravy.
Broth?
Yeah.
Gravy? Oh, man. So this is, you know, I've talked
liquid
about this before.
Gold.
Liquid gold. Eat the frog, you know, accomplishing that biggest thing that knocks over the other dominoes, you know, the thing that can move you forward, whether it's your health, whether it's your finances, your work, your career. Do that thing, the biggest thing first. Get it out of the way. And again, this is a big reason why this was such a huge turning point for me.
Yeah.
And again, I've seen the residual effects, the residue in the opposite direction by not, because it was there with me as after the 100 days for a while.
Mm-hmm.
But then I drifted into experimenting with some other things, and nothing has been more powerful than that portion of writing out things for tomorrow.
Right.
Okay. Knowing what my day is going to be the next day, it's incredible, because your brain, for whatever reason, you know, I could start to talk about why, you know, reticular activating system, but your brain starts to look for things, start to answer questions, starts to process this data before you even get to it. So you hit it running. Like, it's just amazing. I'm so excited because it's the day that this, and this is coming out right now, guys, when you're hearing this show, is the day that this is becoming available to get your hands on. And so, of course, I'm going to have mine. And I cannot wait to implement this and to get started and to absolutely crush with 2017. And that's why I want to bring John on the show again, to just really get you guys in that right mindset, to give you some tools, some insights. But we've got to have that structure. We've got to have that focus to accomplish what we want. And so let's talk about focus next. So focus, what is this whole, what is focus? And your screen just focused at that same moment is awesome. And so what is focus, and why does this matter in this context?
So focus, again, I'm going to go back to my acronym that I mentioned once that's so meaningful. Follow one course until success. In this world where the weapons of mass distraction are literally everywhere, you know, the bright shiny object syndrome is just around the corner. You know, we have our cell phones beeping. We have the notifications in our browser. You know, we have, you know, coworkers like peeking over our cubicles. Like, we have people walking indoors, you know, in the middle of an interview. I mean, we have so many distractions. It is absolutely insane. And if we can really learn the core of what it means to focus, and again, that's that following one course until success, we can actually go deep on something. And there's a great book that I can reference here that's recently been published. It's called Deep Work by Cal Newport. It's a great book. That's actually where I got the word residue from, and how you carry that residue through with you throughout the day, which is why it's so important. Again, going back to that you need to start your day with the right things, because if you start with the wrong things, that residue gets carried over into your right things, and that's a bad thing. So that's why the order of events for your day is important. So when you really sit down and you focus and you say, listen, I am going to be distraction free. And I've given a couple tools here throughout the interview. Here's one more. The tool is called Stay Focused. It's what I highly recommend people look into. You can just install it right in your computer. And then you list, you blacklist all the websites that you're not allowed to go to during your focus time. So I have, you know, Facebook there. I have the Providence College basketball board because, Shawn, you know, I'm a huge Providence College Friar basketball fan. Like, I have certain things that I know are my easy little candy, you know, my easy little wins that my mind wants to go to when I should be focusing on really the deep, meaningful work in my business. And you just click go. And for 1 hour or however long you want to time that for, you literally cannot go to any other thing in your on your website except for what you've whitelisted, which for me is only the one page that I'm currently working on. You can restart your computer. You can do anything you want. You cannot get to any of those sites. They are all blacklisted. Awesome. So stay focused. Because again, if you can actually go deep and just have your trick your mind into that 42 minutes for me, which is that focus time, you will win in a meaningful way.
Awesome. You know, this is something that's really fascinating because everybody listening, there are so many things that you're capable of. And I know that you have big dreams, big visions, and you know that they are tangible. You can accomplish some amazing things, but you just said it, you know, those WMDs, those weapons of mass distraction are super prevalent. And we find ourselves passing time on things that don't really matter to move us forward. Mm-hmm. And why is this happening? And why are tools like this important? And why is a conversation like this important? Is because our brains are hardwired to be distracted because we are literally addicted. You become physiologically addicted to things like Facebook, like Instagram. Mm-hmm. And I love, they're great. They are great. Instagram is the bomb.com. But it's putting things in their proper perspective and also having them in their proper place. So what's going on? So, and I don't know if we talked about this before, John, but when you are looking for something, this is driven by dopamine, right? So we've got this dopamine surge happening in our body, which drives us to seek. And dopamine is important because it's helped humanity to keep seeking, to keep driving, to move us forward. Dopamine is important for that. And the issue is, the internet is perfect for looking for stuff because there's infinite amount of stuff to look for. And I know this has happened to all of us where like I go online, I'm like researching, you know, the other day I was researching water-induced thermogenesis, right? So I'm looking for that. And then maybe there's like a little clip over here of, you know, something to do with Aziz Ansari's favorite water or something. And the next thing you know, I'm watching Aziz Ansari behind the scenes of the actor studio or whatever. And then
now you're watching Master of None on Netflix. And you're
exactly, like, exactly, exactly. And that's how it happens. It's that kind of string of events because there's continuous seeking. Now, the issue is that if you don't find something, you will essentially go insane. Like the system is set up to keep you to seeking and finding. Like you're going to look and you're going to find something. And the internet's perfect for that too, because every time you look, you find. Mm-hmm. Always. And that's why scrolling, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, you look, you find, you look, you find. And you create this incredible drug factory in your own brain where dopamine's getting secreted and you're getting an opioid hit from finding something. Wow. And so you become addicted. Mm-hmm. And so to break that pattern, we need to put some tools in place. Consciousness trumps everything, absolutely. But let's not just leave it up to our consciousness. Let's put up some structure and some things to keep us focused so we can accomplish what we're truly capable of. And on that note, what can we expect with the Mastery Journal? Can you take us, just give us a little preview of what we would be getting with this? I just can't wait. Let's talk about it.
It's really exciting. Again, this to me is like my masterpiece that I've thus far created. I mean, I poured my heart and soul into the Freedom Journal, loved it. That was amazing experience. I learned a lot from it too. And all that learning and just self-awareness went into the Mastery Journal. So I'm just even more excited in a lot of ways for this, because this is going to really take people from where they were struggling by being unproductive on a daily basis, by having no plan, so their discipline was lacking, and then by just really being, you know, a human being. So you're distracted by everything. I mean, that's the world that we live in. I mean, there's a reason why people say, oh my God, I've been thinking so hard, my head hurts. Because guess what? It really does hurt your brain to concentrate. So guess what? Your brain knows that. And it says, well, we'd rather do things that it doesn't really take so much energy because we don't know when our next meal's coming for real. Because, you know, I'm the brain. I don't know that we have a fridge necessarily full of food. So, like, let's conserve the energy and let's just do the easy things. And you know, that's the quick little dopamine hits and stuff like that. So it's hard to concentrate. It's hard to focus. That's why we all procrastinate. And that's why the Mastery Journal will be your guide to mastering productivity, discipline, and focus in 100 days. Something that, you know, I'm really fired up about is that winning tomorrow today. So that's where you start. You start by winning tomorrow today by writing down what that plan is going to be. And then after that, and you saw this within the Freedom Journal, you know, I had to carry this forward because it's so important. Then you do start that actual day, post your morning routine with that one mindset of abundance. You know, what are you most grateful for? And I challenge everybody to don't keep writing the same thing. Like, yes, we know you're grateful for your family, for your friends, for all that. We get it. That can be days 1 through 10. But, you know, once it gets deeper into that, like, really start looking around. Like, what are you really grateful for? Keep trying to challenge yourself to find something new and different and exciting. And then once you pass that part, then you enter, Shawn, the first of 4 sessions. And those 4 sessions, again, I brought in the Pomodoro technique. I brought in Parkinson's Law. And you will set an actual focus time that works for you and then a refresh time that, again, works for you. And then you'll set your timer and boom, you start and you're off to the races. At the end of that time, guess what? You'll be shocked, but you'll actually have accomplished that goal. Just like we're all shocked when in college, you know, we had that one day to cram that paper that we've been putting off all day, I mean, all semester. And lo and behold, the next morning it was done because that's all the time we had. So you'll accomplish that one goal within that 42, you know, whatever that minute focus time is. Again, for me, it's 42 minutes. But then this is where a really cool thing comes in. The Mastery Journal is big about self-evaluation. And I first of all guide you within the beginning sections of the Mastery Journal on how to self-evaluate yourself. But every single one of those 4 sessions that you're going to do throughout the day, you are going to give yourself a productivity score and a discipline score at the end. You're going to self-evaluate yourself, scale of 1 to 10. So by the end of the day, you'll know what your daily productivity score is and your daily discipline score is. Then, of course, we're going to look back and we're going to say, like, hey, what was working and what was not working within those 4 sessions? And then we're getting down to the section of how are you going to win tomorrow today? And that's for the next morning. And so what's really going to be amazing for people is that when they get to the end of the day and they look back over like what their biggest wins were and what their struggles were, they're going to realize that in those 4 sessions, they accomplished more than they used to accomplish all week. Like, I'm not just saying that for a reason. Like, I put this to the test. You know, I have a test group of people that have crushed the Freedom Journal. I put them through the Mastery Journal. This is like independently across the board. These things were coming back from people who hadn't heard it from each other. And they were saying, I'm literally doing more in these 4 25-minute sessions than I was doing all week of actual meaning, of meaningful, deep work. Every 10 days, we go into a deep 10-day recap. So in the Freedom Journal, it was a quarterly review every 25 days. This is the Mastery. It's a lot more self-evaluation within the Mastery Journal. So I brought it down to every 10 days. You're going to do a 10-day recap where you're going to actually now find out what your productivity score was for those last 10 days, what your discipline score was averaged out for those last 10 days. And guess what? You're now going to be able to look back at every 10th day and see where you're improving, where you're not, you know, where you're struggling more with. Like, maybe you had X score, you know, week on day 10, but Y score on week 20. Like, what's the difference? Why? Is it better? Is it worse? And so this is going to be a big self-evaluation model that's going to keep your fire, your feet to the fire, and make sure that, again, by day 100, you're reprogrammed. You are now a master of what it means to be productive, disciplined, and focused on a daily basis.
That's so exciting. Now, is the Freedom Journal a prerequisite for the Mastery Journal? Should you
Great question. It's a very common one. So much so, actually, that I created an entire video that is just titled Freedom Journal versus Mastery Journal, and I kind of go into detail. So there's absolutely no prerequisites for some people. And this is a big piece of feedback that I got was, John, what if I don't really have a big goal that I want to accomplish right now? I said, well, you know, if you don't really feel it that way, number one, that's too bad. But number two, maybe the Freedom Journal is not for you right now. But the Mastery Journal would be the answer in this situation where you just know that, hey, I need to sit down and master these three skills. And then maybe this will unlock some big idea or goal that I can then accomplish with the Freedom Journal. Or on the flip side, maybe you know that you want to crush that number one goal first and like launch a podcast or a book or do this or that. But then post-launch, you want to keep that momentum going. Like Shawn said, he's kind of dropped off a little bit. That's where the Mastery Journal should have slid right in and just kept his feet to the fire and actually brought him to the next level, because now he's accomplished this big goal. Now, how do we become a master of the productivity, discipline, and focus to just crush it?
Perfect, awesome, man. Awesome. Yeah. And you just said a couple of great things. And, you know, it's not the fact that I wasn't doing things or doing great things. It's the fact of, you know how much potential you have, you know, and everybody listening, you know how much potential you have in accomplishing amazing things. And this is something he just said, of putting your feet to the fire to draw that out of you. And why I'm kind of geeking out about this and so excited about this new journal is the fact that I saw firsthand. And even when he told me about the idea with the Freedom Journal, I was like, it sounds like a great idea, but I had no idea that it would impact me so much by actually just putting it in play. I put it in play and seeming magic started happening. It was absolutely amazing. So really quick before you go, man, I've got a rapid fire, three quick questions for you, man. See what your answers are. And I've never done this before, but because you're a friend of the show, I want to ask and just see what you got to say.
Because you're all right. JLD.
What food can you not live without?
Bone broth. I do the JLD bone broth delight every day. I got residue of mine right there.
Perfect. Awesome. All right. What is your favorite form of exercise?
The rowing machine. I just started doing that about 6 months ago because I heard that that's how people in 300 got ripped, and I was hooked.
Awesome. Awesome. And your favorite way to de-stress?
Meditate on that Chase lounge right behind me every single day. There I am meditating and journaling. And those are just two things that center me at the beginning of every day, part of my morning routine.
Perfect, my man. John Lee Dumas, can you let everybody know where they can pick up the new journal and where they can connect with you online?
So January 23rd through February 24th of 2017, the Mastery Journal Kickstarter campaign is live. So head over there. You can pick up the Mastery Journal. We have combo packs of the Mastery Journal and the Freedom Journal. So you can just get all the awesomeness in one place. And that is simply themasteryjournal.com. Podcasts are evergreen. So if you're listening to this after February 24th, you're still in luck because themasteryjournal.com will be an amazing webpage. You can learn more and pick up your own there.
Awesome, my man. One of my favorite people on the planet.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for joining us and sharing your brilliance, man. I appreciate you and can't wait to see what's next for you, man. Thank you.
Awesome.
Thanks, Jade. Take care, John.
Thanks, Shawn. Bye, guys.
Kate, we said hi.
So that was John Lee Dumas from Entrepreneur on Fire, a.k.a. EO Fire. And you can check him out at entrepreneuronfire.com or eofire.com. Epic podcast, just true pioneer, seven-day-a-week podcast.
Wow.
What?
15.
When people were telling him, when he was telling people that he's going to do that, they literally said, bro, you're crazy. You're crazy pants.
Yes.
Here's your straight jacket. What size do you wear? But he really rose up and he made it happen. And to the degree that, you know, Best of iTunes Award, he turned it in. And this is when he didn't have much of anything. He didn't know anything about online anything and was able to create a multi-million dollar business and serving, because it's not just about making a dollar, it's making a difference as well. So he has that fulfillment tied to it, and you can see it in the way that he presents himself. Mm-hmm. You could see it in the way that he operates in the world, and he's just a genuinely good person. He's just a good guy, and to have that opportunity to, you know, hang out with him and to spend time together, I got to see that firsthand, you know, because some people, the characters that you see on TV, they're not the same in real life.
Exactly.
You know, but he's such a genuine guy because he kind of got that radio swag voice to him, just that radio vibe. And then you meet him, it's just like that's who he is in person. You know, he's mm-hmm. such a cool person. He's entertaining. He's super knowledgeable. But more than anything, he's so giving. And with that said, he's also about his business. He knows how to structure things so that he wins as well, and that enables him to do more good.
Absolutely.
And I think we need to be more conscious about tying that into the things that we're moving towards, you know, especially financially. How are you going to serve? You know, tie this to something bigger, because maybe it's helping your community. How can you help them if you don't have? So how can you build yourself up to be able to better serve in whatever way? And it's not always money is going to be the issue. It's going to be, you know, being able to allocate your time properly to give your time, which is the most valuable commodity that you have.
How about your energy and vitality right. as well?
How can putting that behind your thrust in the world to become healthier,
yep.
that's your means of serving and being there to serve your family, to be able to protect and to provide for your family is predicated on how good do you feel, you know, and that's so powerful. But are you focused on that?
Right.
How productive are you in that? How's your discipline in that? And what tools can we use to make it happen? Because it sounds great, like, okay, I'm going to have more discipline. I'm going to focus on this. But are you really? Or can you use a little bit of an assist?
You probably can. Because if naturally you're going to, again, these are weapons of mass distraction.
Yeah.
These are weaponized. These things can throw you off course, can annihilate your purpose, your plan, your hope.
Perfectly designed. Like, they're designed in mind to pull you out of where you're going to get you addicted. And that's all good. Like, you know, it's kind of an ethical thing to want, you know, if they're doing something that's a good product, to want you to be a part of it for sure. Mm-hmm. But the degree of ninjaing your consciousness and taking away from your main focus is just amazing. Mm-hmm. And today we've got more distraction, more opportunity as well than ever. And it's really about honing these skills and attributes and utilizing a tool. And again, I'm just kind of geeking out about this and excited because I know what I experienced with utilizing this journal that he created. And man, it's just like, I thought it was a great idea. Like, it sounds great on paper, but when I got it and I started to put it in play, and I had a reason behind it. Like, I'm going to utilize this. I've got this serious goal that I want to accomplish and I'm going to use this and see what happens.
Right.
And looking back, like, as I look through these pages, I cannot believe what I accomplished in 100 days.
Wow.
And we all have that capacity to literally blow ourselves away and the people around us with what we can do. And so thank you guys so much for tuning into the show today. I appreciate you immensely. Make sure to utilize these tools. Take action. It's not just about being able to do more push-ups. When it comes to your health and your fitness, it's really about being a complete human being and being healthy in all areas of your life. And that's what I would really strive to bring to you every time out of the gate, and make sure that we bring things that are helping to move you closer to being the best version of yourself. So I appreciate you immensely. We've got some amazing shows coming up, amazing guests. Take care. Have an amazing day. I'll talk with you soon.